Going on YouTube, this is Epic Gnosis doing a short video on my gaming computer. I'm gonna start with some specs for you. The motherboard, Asus Rampage Extreme, CPU QX9750, one step below the 9770, which is the highest version of the Core 2 quads that you can get. Here is an EK water block, which is used on the 4870 X2s. I have two of those in Crossfire, so that's pretty nice. Sound card is an X-Fi, Supreme X-Fi. Came with the motherboard. Has the SPDIF out on it, which is really nice. If you're using gaming headphones, you can get the 5.1 surround sound going on. Hard drives, Western Digital Velociraptors. One is for the Windows 7 operating system, the other is for movies, pictures, and audio. That memory there is Corsair Dominator. You can probably tell by the fan. Water blocks are Apogee GTZ on the CPU, and it's from Swiftech, and there's another Swiftech water block on the Northbridge. You guys with the Core i7s, you don't have to worry about Northbridge anymore, because that's all integrated with the memory controllers and all that good stuff. But the tubing is all half inch tubing, as you can see there. It's I use little basic clamps on there. That water pump you see down at the right is not even on. I'll tell you why in a minute. This is the water cooling portion of the computer. This is a picture of what it used to look like before. That water pump down at the bottom is a Hydor Seltz. It runs at 720 gallons per minute, or per hour, I'm sorry. It was good until the impeller broke, and then when I tried to find the impeller for it, it was the same price as the pump. So I said, this is garbage, I'm gonna go ahead and buy another one. Something that's going to be a little bit more reliable. This one costs three times as much, but it's called an Einhem. It's a beast, and you can see that bad boy is rolling at 900 gallons an hour. Yeah, I'm having some problems with water saturation in the radiator because it's pumping so much water, but it works. You can just underclock it until I can figure out what I'm going to do with some Peltiers or whatever. As you can see here, that's all wired up to this PWM and a Meanwell 600 watt power supply. It's a PWM used to control fan speed, which in turn controls the fan or the temperature. I also have that little white distribution block there. That's for my Peltiers when I get them hooked up inside of there and I get this thing running how I want to. Temperatures will probably get all the way down to maybe positive 5 degrees Celsius, so that'll be real nice, because I'm using dielectric grease behind the CPU socket already, because I used a compressor. Basically, it's a phase change compressor that cools down water by using Freon, which is 134A, and compression, and it cools the computer down. And that broke on me, so I had to use that big old radiator there. Power supply is a Meanwell 600 watt power supply, so that should be enough to power all the needs, everything that I have. All that wood is there is custom built. It's used to house everything, which is really nice. You have that wooden plank there is used to hide the wires. This computer is sitting right next to the entertainment center, just so you know. I have all my gaming stuff hooked up to a 46-inch TV and a 17-inch monitor, which when my girlfriend is complaining, "Oh, you're on a game too much, you're playing a computer too much," I can just go ahead and switch over to the 17-inch monitor, which is sitting right next to the sofa, so that I can go ahead and game while she's watching TV. I got some pictures for you after this to show you a little bit about what it looked like before. If you have any questions or comments, want to know what I'm going to do next, I'm going to have some new videos coming up soon. I know the audio is crappy. I'm sorry about that. I'll probably buy a new microphone. I'm using a wireless microphone right now, and it's not working too well. So Hope you enjoyed this video, enjoy the pictures, and you guys at YouTube have a great day.